Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to downgrade your Windows 11 installation to Windows 10. Now on this computer, I currently have Windows 11 22H2 running, which is the latest version that's available at the time of recording this video. And if your computer has upgraded from Windows 10 to Windows 11 in the last 10 days, you can go ahead and open your settings and then go to the Windows Update tab. Here you want to find Advanced Options, and then you want to find Recovery. Now in this recovery section, you might have an option that says go back to Windows 10. If I remember correctly, it's only for the first 10 days after your computer has upgraded from Windows 10 to Windows 11. In my case, I don't have that option and I have to manually downgrade to Windows 10. Now unfortunately, this means that I'll lose all of my files and apps. So before you go ahead and follow this guide, you need to make sure that you have a backup of all of the files on your computer, whether it's on an external hard drive, a USB flash drive or cloud storage. You need to make a backup of your files. Now to perform the downgrade from Windows 11 to Windows 10, you'll need the latest Windows 10 ISO file, which I already have downloaded and saved here. And I have a separate guide on how you can get this Windows 10 ISO file, which I'll link in the description of this video and in the cards now. But once you have this Windows 10 ISO file, make sure that you save it inside of your local disk C's root drive, because the downgrade process is going to delete all of your user files, so you can't save it inside of any of these folders that are saved in your user directory. So once you have this Windows 10 ISO file saved on your computer inside the C drive, you can go ahead and right-click on it, and your right-click menu might look different than mine, but you just want to find the option that says Open With and then click on that. And then make sure that you find the Windows Explorer app on your list of available options, and then just click on OK or Always to open it with Windows Explorer. Once you've done that, you'll see all of these files that are saved inside the ISO file. If you don't, just go over to this PC and then just right-click on the DVD drive called ESD-ISO and then click on Open. And once you see these files, go ahead and double-click on the setup.exe file. This will launch the Windows 10 installation wizard, and once you get to this first screen, just click on this option that says Change How Windows Setup Downloads Updates, and once you've clicked on that, change this setting to Not Right Now, and then click on Next. It'll then do some checks on your PC. Next, you'll see the Notices and License Terms screen. You can read through this if you want. I'm just going to go ahead and click on Accept. And now we'll need to choose what to keep. Now, unfortunately, we can't keep our personal files and apps or even our personal files, because as this message says down here, we're trying to install an older version of Windows. So we won't be able to keep anything, but we will be able to go back to Windows 10. So just go ahead and click on Next. Then it prompts us if we want to continue using this selection. Again, you need to have a backup of all of your files on this computer, as everything will be deleted. I'm just going to go ahead and click Yes, because I do want Windows 10 on this computer. It'll do some more checks to make sure that we're ready to install. Once you're ready to install, you'll see this screen where it says we'll install Windows 10 Pro, and in this case, we'll keep nothing. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on Install to start the process. Now, depending on if you have a solid state drive or a hard drive, this process might take a while. If you have a solid state drive, it could take anywhere from around 30 minutes to 45 minutes. If you have a hard drive, it could even take up to 2 hours. So you can go ahead and do something else while this is running. Maybe go and get a cup of coffee and then come back and see how far it's gone. This is the end of the first Windows installation screen, and now it's going to restart and give you the second part of the Windows downgrade or upgrade screen. Once the downgrade process is done, you'll see the Windows 10 setup screens. On the first one, you'll need to select your region, so you can just select the correct region and then click on Yes. On the next screen, you'll need to choose your keyboard layout, so just go ahead and choose your default keyboard layout and then click on Yes. And on the next screen, you can add a second keyboard layout by clicking on Add Layout. If you don't use a second keyboard, just click on Skip. Then you'll need to create a new user account. So you can just click into that box and then start typing a new username and then click on Next. If you wanted to use a password, you can also type a new password, or you can just leave this blank if you don't want any password. Then click on Next. And on the next screen, you can choose the privacy settings for your device. On this screen, I recommend that you turn off every slider, and then you can just click on Accept. On the last screen, they'll prompt you to use Cortana. If you're interested in using Cortana, just go ahead and click on Accept. If you're not going to use Cortana, just click on Not Now. And then lastly, you'll see a screen similar to this, which will display a few different messages, and then you'll be taken to your desktop on Windows 10. Once you've gone through all of the Windows 10 setup screens, you'll get to your desktop. And something you should do before you start using your computer is just go down to your Start menu and click on that, and then go to Settings, go to Update and Security, and then just check for updates and let it install all of the latest available updates. And by doing these Windows updates, you'll also get some drivers that's needed for your system to function properly. If you do see this option that says View Optional Updates, you can click on that. And in the optional updates, you should see some driver updates, and you can just click on the arrow to expand it. And here you'll see some driver updates that Windows 10 has identified that should be installed on your computer. So you can go ahead and check all of these items, and then click on download and install, so all of these drivers can get installed through Windows Update. I'll also link some guides on the screen now on how to properly install or update the drivers on your Windows 10 or Windows 11 computer if they're available. If they're not available yet, just go ahead and watch the other helpful videos linked on the screen now. Don't forget to like the video. See you in the next one.